Fox 5 Health News. We told you earlier about the first baby with Zika-related birth defects born in New York City. The health department says the city stands ready to help families caring for an infant with microcephaly. That's what the condition is called.
Let's unpack this with Fox 5's medical contributor, Dr. Devi Nampiya-Parampil. She is here to talk to us about this. Very concerning.
Yeah.
Especially considering that this may be the result, possibly, of sexual transmission. Possibly?
Possibly, or travel. I mean, it's hard to know too much about the particular patient or the mom because privacy concerns. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we try to protect the privacy of the people involved. Now, of course, you know, microcephaly, what it means is that the baby has a small head. So it's not the cosmetic concern, it's the fact that maybe the brain isn't developing properly. And of course, you know, you might only discover what all of that entails later on as you go along. Right,
right.
So the things that we worry about with patients that might be infected with Zika, in terms of the baby, the things we worry about is later in life that they might have vision problems, that they could have hearing problems, language problems, and of course motor problems. So for a family who has a baby with Zika, the things that they would with microcephaly from Zika, the things that they would have to be prepared for is, you know, how are they going to manage things like incontinence, for example? Will they be able to take the baby out and take the baby around in the community, or later as that person becomes an adult? Will the baby, as they grow up, be able to help with grooming and dressing and moving around and other things, because that puts you at risk for pneumonia or other life-threatening conditions.
Right, right.
Like you could get pressure ulcers and other skin problems that can also cause cause damage. Now, the CDC is actually separating this out into three groups. So there are kids that have microcephaly, kids that might be born with microcephaly, mm-hmm. where you at least know to look out for this, right? But there are some cases where the mother might have tested positive for Zika, or the baby might have tested positive for Zika early on, but they don't know for sure. Maybe there is no microcephaly, so will there be a problem or not, right? I think that's very anxiety provoking, because for that family, they have to watch also, you know, throughout
development. The child's
life. Yeah, exactly, till they have an adult, because they don't know, will this person develop problems later on, especially during puberty with the changes in hormones.
Gotcha, right.
People can develop seizures too, and they don't even know it. It's only the people around them that might know sometimes.
Mm-hmm. This might seem like a silly question, but there is no way to reverse course, right? There's no way to reverse the effects of the Zika virus or microcephaly once it has set in.
Not right now. So in terms of the Zika virus, even though they're doing a lot of testing to find out if the baby might have it or if the mom might have it, there is no treatment at this point, and there is no vaccine.
And now it looks like it might be easier to spread to, right? A different type of mosquito they found can carry it potentially.
Well, so this is a developing report. So they found that a more common mosquito, common meaning in Brazil, it's sort of the house mosquito, and it could be here as well, but it can actually carry Zika, but we don't know if it can transmit it from the mosquito to us,
gotcha.
Right? So sometimes you can think about it like, you know, if you have pets like cats or dogs, for example, sometimes they get sick, but it doesn't mean you're going to get the same thing from them. So in the same way, even though mosquitoes do carry Zika, it is sort of a separate species that we have been studying so far.
Gotcha, gotcha.
Dr. Devi, thank you. It's concerning to a lot of people, especially a lot of women who are going on their
honeymoon. It really sort of limits where you want to go. I know it's true.